Hi, thank you for tuning in. So what about foreign land ownership? Would you consider owning land in a foreign jurisdiction? Interesting question. Incidentally, I personally have been thinking about this a lot lately. And you know, if I can be blunt about it, it's just my opinion, you don't have to take it, but I think that's really a question for people who've achieved a certain amount of financial success, right? If you haven't bought your kakwota in Syokimau, I really don't think you need to be grappling with the question of whether or not to buy land in Tanzania or South Africa, for example, right? I think you need to start here first. After you've accumulated enough here that you can reasonably start to think about hedging against risks because of having too much in one pot, then you can think about diversifying and spreading your risk and exposure and buying land elsewhere. That's just my take. But in general, I think it's a good idea for the simple reason that it allows you to diversify and hedge against your risks. It is also potentially a very prudent way to grow your wealth faster in other jurisdictions than you would in Kenya. And while it's difficult to find other places on the continent and even in the world, to be honest, you can read any number of reports that have been released in the last 3 years, Kenya has consistently outperformed every major real estate capital in the world. That says a lot, Nairobi specifically. We focus on Nairobi because it's the economic hub of the country, but it's true in other parts of Kenya. And in our experience, even better in other parts of Kenya. Rural parts of Kenya are experiencing larger margins of growth on an annual basis than Nairobi, which is outperforming places like New York. Puts things into perspective, right? I'm not saying it costs the same. It's a lot cheaper to buy land in Ukambani or Lodwar or even Kwale than it is in New York by far. But what I'm saying is, if I had $1 million to spend today and I bought, let me change that. If I had $1 million today to spend, I have options. I can spend the money in the US and buy land in the US easily. But for the same $1 million, I can probably buy a couple of thousand acres in Kwale or somewhere else in the country. And why would that be good for me? For me, it's good because based on the appreciation rate annually in places like Kwale, Amboseli area, even in Laikipia County, I will gain a lot more equity. I will grow that value a lot faster than I will in New York. Simple fact. So whether or not you invest in other jurisdictions should not only be looked at from the point of hedging against risks and diversifying your investments, but also in terms of what will give you the most attractive returns over the same period of time. And in my view, that's a positive discussion to have. We ourselves are currently looking. Hopefully in the near future, we'll have some interesting opportunities to share with you. Places like Tanzania are interesting. It is possible in certain pockets of Tanzania, very few though, but it is possible for you as a Kenyan or a Ugandan even to buy land in Tanzania. It's also possible to do so in Uganda. You could buy land even in Sudan. You could go as far south as Cape Town. Cape Town, interestingly, is a lot cheaper than our coastal region as far as beach properties are concerned on the Eastern Cape. So good place to look at. Places like Angola are performing really well in real estate, especially if it's developed real estate, because there's such a huge demand for quality spaces that have not existed up to now. So in my view, do your homework as always. Don't just go on someone else's recommendation. Get the hard facts, look at the data. If you can go visit, even better, and make the leap if it is prudent enough for you to do so. I hope that helps. If you have comments or questions to make, or maybe you have an experience investing outside of Kenya, please share that with us. We'd be happy to hear from you. You can do so through our YouTube channel or send us an email at www.goshenacquisitions.com, and we'll be happy to engage with you. You've been watching Own Land in Kenya. I am Solomon Wangwe. Stay tuned for more information on strategic land investments.